Well, it is at this point in my career that I wish I had a different job, because the last thing I want to do is make a video on skull holes, aka the skull foramina, and have to deal with all these little updates on my computer. Just a minute, let me hit snooze on that guy. Okay, I'll point out what goes through these holes if I remember as I go along, but you don't have to know what goes through the holes. It's just kind of interesting. Maybe it will help you remember, especially the next chapter that you're going to go through will be chapter 13, and you know, when you go through the cranial nerves, you'll be like, oh yeah, I remember that went through skull hole number blah blah blah, or which, you know, went through the foramen spinosum, etc. So our first skull hole that everybody likes is this one right here. It's the biggest one. It is the foramen magnum right here. I forgot what it was called for a minute. And it's the easiest one too, because it means big hole. So that's the foramen magnum, this big thing here, and you can probably guess what goes through there. It's up in this part of the skull, we're obviously going to have the brain, and at the base here we're going to have the brain stem, but underneath the foramen magnum what's going to come out is the spinal cord. So the spinal cord goes through the foramen magnum. Let's do this hole next, since I see it here. This is the external acoustic meatus. This is your outer ear hole, the external acoustic meatus, or you could call it the external auditory meatus. We're going to have it on both sides here. See this one? So this should be not too hard for you to recognize. Now, if it has an external, sometimes it has an internal hole, foramen. So if we look on the inside of the skull, here, right here, this is the internal acoustic meatus, or internal auditory meatus, and it has it on both sides. Do you see it over here? See it right here? This is in the temporal bone, and in this internal acoustic meatus, you think, well, that's just my ear hole, but there are quite a few things that can go through there. Actually, there are two cranial nerves that are going to go through this hole. There's going to be cranial nerve 7, and there's going to be cranial nerve 8. Not something you have to memorize, but there are 12 cranial nerves, and so those are two cranial nerves that go through there. All right, let's do this little hole right here. Now, to find this hole, you look for the foramen magnum, and it's right on the inside of the foramen magnum. So let me find it on this side. Look from underneath. How I am, see where I am. This is the hypoglossal canal, and the hypoglossal canal, there it is, there's the hypoglossal canal, and that hypoglossal canal is just a canal for your 12th cranial nerve, the hypoglossal nerve, to go through there. Another hole. Let's do this, these big holes right here. See these big holes on either side here? Now, the way I usually find these is I turn the skull upside down and I look where this big occipital bone is going to go up and attach to the sphenoid bone. And then on both sides we have that hole, hole here, and the hole here. And these holes are called, well, this is the foramen lacerum. So these would be the foramina lacerum. Bam, and oh, it's so hard to do this when I'm just looking into the screen. That one right there, those two holes. You poke from the bottom. Bam. Now, mostly in life, these guys in the foramen lacerum, they are covered with it. And like if you're a living human being and not a little skull that all of the organic debris has been removed, that foramen lacerum is closed up. But in real life, like in your head right now, there'd be a branch of the facial nerve, that's cranial nerve 7, going through there, and there'd be some blood vessels going through there. But for the most part, it's closed up by some cartilage. Let's do these little holes. Now, these little holes might be hard to see, but there are little tiny holes in this cribriform plate, and so you can call them the cribriform foramina. Foramina is plural for foramen, and so those are the cribriform foramina. I like to call them the olfactory foramina, so you can call them either the cribriform foramina or the olfactory foramina. And the reason I like to call them the olfactory foramina is because the olfactory nerves, the olfactory tracts are going to be coming from the brain up to this region, and the olfactory bulbs lie on either side of this. Do you know what this thing is right here? Sticking up? your little Cristagalli. So they're going to lay on each side of this, and the olfactory nerves are going to go down, and they'll come out into the nose. And so, sorry about my, I should turn off my email so you don't have to hear that. Okay. Another hole. Let's do these little eye holes here. See where my pointer's coming out there? Just barely. Let's do it this way. See where my pointer's going in? No. Okay. There are holes in the back of the eye sockets. You can probably see it better in this other eye socket over here. Over here, right there, that hole. That's your optic canal. In your optic canal, your optic nerves comes out through there. There's a good shot of it. You can see a clear little hole there. That's the optic canal. The optic nerve comes out through there and attaches to your eye. That's the cranial nerve too. We have some fissures that you can see in the back of the eyes. This is the superior orbital fissure at the top, and the inferior orbital fissure at the bottom. It is very hard for me to do this backwards. The inferior orbital fissure is down here, and the superior orbital fissure is at the top. At the superior orbital fissure, or foramen, superior orbital fissure, that's a place where you can see it very clearly right now, that little slit right beside the optic canal. And that superior orbital fissure is where cranial nerve 3, 4, and 6 comes through. Those are important cranial nerves. And the inferior orbital fissure, cranial nerve 5 is going to come out of there, and some blood vessels. And so these are these little slits down here in the very bottom. You're going to hear about cranial nerve number 5 quite a bit, because cranial nerve number 5 has many branches, so a lot of these holes allow branches of cranial nerve 5 to come out and serve the face. Cranial nerve 5 is for sensation of the face. Here are two more holes up here. Now on this side it really looks like a hole, so that would be the supraorbital foramen. If it's not a complete hole, we call it a supraorbital notch. I don't care whether you call it a supraorbital foramen or supraorbital notch. And down below the eye, down here, we have the infraorbital foramen, and they're named because of their location according to the orbits of the eyes. The supraorbital foramen has branches of that cranial nerve 5 that comes out to innervate the face for sensation, and it also has blood vessels that come through there. And the same exact thing for down here, this infraorbital foramen. Remember, you don't have to know what comes in and out of these, but you just wouldn't have holes in your skull for no reason. Usually always blood vessels or nerves are coming through those, through the skull to the face and to the muscles. So you can move your muscles or feel your muscles, feel sensation of skin, etc., and blood vessels have to come out. Down here we have some holes. These are your mental foramina. So here's a mental foramen, and here's another mental foramen. And as you would suspect, we have blood vessels and nerves that come out through those holes. We have branches of that fifth cranial nerve coming out, and you have blood vessels. So, where do we want to go from here? Holes. Let's get to some hard holes. There are three holes. I can see them fine from here. Move it around here. Three holes that are going to come out of the sphenoid. Let me get adjusted here. Here's the first hole up here. This is the foramen spinosum. The next hole, going down, I have to look as I do it, is the foramen ovale. And the next little hole, is the foramen spinosum. So we have the, up here, I cannot do this looking in a mirror, rotundum, ovale, and spinosum. They go in order. I call it shopping at Ross. There we go. Rotundum, ovale, and spinosum. On this side, we have the foramen rotundum, the foramen ovale, and the foramen spinosum. and they're all in the sphenoid. Through the foramen spinosum, or the foramen rotundum, the first one, we have cranial nerve, a branch of cranial nerve 5 coming through there. Same with the ovale. And on spinosum, we have a branch of cranial nerve 5, because that's for sensation, coming out, and also a branch of the middle meningeal artery. Here is something I haven't mentioned. It's not really a hole, but it's a little indentation called the lacrimal fossa in the lacrimal bone. And what it does is it contains, there's the nasal bone, a maxillary bone, and then the lacrimal bone. And you'll see there's an indentation when you fill your skull in there, and that's the lacrimal fossa, and that's where it contains the lacrimal sac to allow tears to go from the eyes down into the nasal cavity. I know some ones that we've missed, some holes on the bottom. These holes are going to be very hard to see. The first hole, let's get it here, might not be too hard to see. It's a nice hole in the petrous portion of the temporal bone called the carotid canal. And the carotid canal is going to be right near the jugular foramen. And in the carotid canal, you have a branch of the internal carotid artery that goes through there. The jugular foramen, I have to move around and see this big sloppy hole here. It's a big sloppy hole. I'm going to move it around in different ways. It's on this side as well. Let me see if I can put my pointer through it in that direction. It's between the temporal bone and the occipital bone. It's a big, wide, open foramen, and that is your jugular foramen. So the jugular foramen, and that takes quite a bit of manipulation of the skull, so I'm not sure you're going to get that in this video. But the jugular foramen allows part of the internal jugular canal, internal jugular vein to go through there, along with some other things. So, and I'm blanking on what else goes through there right now, so I'll think of it here in a minute, but internal jugular foramen goes there for sure. Some other nerves. Now, do you see any other holes on there we've forgotten? This we call your nose hole. Just kidding. Let's see. Oh, I know. The mandibular foramen. Here on the inside, you'll have to get a hold of a skull and see this one. This is the mandibular foramen. Branches of the trigeminal nerve go down in there for sensation. This is the mental foramen because of the chin location, and this is the mandibular foramen. I feel like we've gone over everything. I feel like we've gone over every little hole. Oh, one more. Stylo. Here's a hole. Now, let me see if I have another skull. I do have another skull right here. There's a little hole right here. Beep, 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 beep. There's usually a styloid process coming off here, and here's a mastoid process. So this is the stylomastoid foramen, and a branch of the 7th cranial nerve comes out through there. Let me see if I have it on another skull. This other skull might be easier for you to view quite a few things. Whoop, that's what it's going to look like on my practical day. Look at a point to all those holes in there. Okay. Dun, dun, dun. Can you see the jugular foramen in that? It's this big, wide open hole. Oh, if I can do it. Here. Let's see. Here is a styloid process. See that little sticky out thing right there? Pointing to it? Here's the mastoid process. So between the two, there should be a stylomastoid foramen right there. That little hole for a 7th cranial nerve to go through. Okay, I'm sorry it's so hard to do the skull on a video. It just is. See any holes that you recognize? What's the big hole in the middle? It's this big hole? Yes, the foramen magnum. What are these holes? Right here. This one. And this one on this side. This one. And this one. Yes, the foramen lacerum. From this view right here, what is this hole? Yes, that is the internal acoustic meatus. I am just sure you're getting these correct. What is this big, crazy-looking hole here between the occipital bone and the temporal bone? Yes, that is the jugular foramen. You cannot see the carotid canal, by the way, from this view. You have to turn the skull over. And there we have the carotid canal right there, right near our jugular foramen. What is this big hole here? What's that big hole? It's not just your ear hole, it's your external acoustic meatus. What is this hole? That's the infraorbital foramen. What would this be called right here, this region? Supraorbital foramen. What is this little region right here I'm sticking this down into? Lacrimal fossa. And maybe if we turn it a little bit, you can actually see the hole. You can see the groove. There we go. Now you see the hole from that view. All right. And over here, we have this hole on the inside of the foramen magnum. Which one would that be? That'd be your hypoglossal canal. And we have three holes inside the sphenoid that go in order. First one, up high, close to the superior orbital fissure. It's the foramen rotundum. The next one is the foramen ovale. And then the next one, I can't even find it on this side, the next one is the foramen spinosum. You go in order. Rotundum, rotundum, ovale, spinosum. And then what are these guys right here? These would be leading to the eye sockets, so these are the optic canals. And up here, these little holes. Those are the olfactory foramina or the craviform foramina. In the eyes, see those nice, that V, those lateral Vs? The superior part is the superior orbital fissure, and the bottom part is the inferior orbital fissure. And the holes that you see up there, hopefully my pointer will go through it. And there's my pointer barely going through there. That's the optic canal. And I hope this video has helped you more than it has hurt you. But when you know your skull foramina, you need to know them from a variety of views, on the actual skull itself and on pictures.